in Florida. The first thing I grabbed was this vintage blue milk glass jar. I think it held Jim Beam alcohol. I ended up picking that up for the booth. Then I grabbed these jeans for Poshmark. I also grabbed these Levi's ribcage jeans. And then I thought this brass carousel giraffe was so cute. I grabbed that for the booth, as well as these cute strawberry floral glasses. Then we stopped at another Goodwill and I found this Elle Anthropology mug. I really liked the gold. I rarely see the gold. And then I grabbed this vest for myself, and then they had so much milk glass. I ended up grabbing a few that I don't see as often, and so I'm going to put these in the booth. And then I really liked these pink marble goblets. Thrift with me at Goodwill for clothes to resell on Poshmark and eBay. The first thing I grabbed was this Lily Pulitzer mini skirt. Then I saw these Zara shorts I loved, but they were a little too pricey for me to resell. I found a pair of Lily Pulitzer shorts and blue tags were active. I think this may be the scariest antique mall I've ever been to. I stopped at one in Mount Dora, Florida called Village Antique Mall. Spotted some Fiesta wear right when we walked in, and then I loved the lights in this booth. I thought it was super cute. I'm a sucker for dried flowers. I love these little boho prints. And then I spotted some Otagiri little salt and pepper shakers. I love these little houses. I think they're so cute. And then this I definitely had when I was little. I think my mom packed my lunch with this. You can't tell me that this is not the same person. You couldn't tell me. I loved this picture so much. I had to show you. And then I've been loving stained glass lamps. I wish I could have brought these home with me, but these ones were super expensive. Then I saw the most Tupperware I have ever seen in my entire life. I loved these cookie cutters, but I did leave them behind for $30. And then I found another picture I really loved. I thought this one was super cute. And then I found this Fiesta Ware mug. I actually bought this for our kitchen. And then the glassware in this booth was just so pretty. Let's go thrifting at a Goodwill in Florida. First, I saw these plates. I thought they were cute and I could add them to the booth for St. Patrick's Day, but I didn't end up picking them up because of the price. I did end up grabbing this cat dish, even though Goodwill priced it at $5.99 and it said $3.99 on the back, but I thought it was so cute. I grabbed it. I know, I'm the problem. I'm so sorry. And then I did grab this Brewmate. I thought it was such a pretty color and I think I'm gonna use it as a gift for someone, put like a decal on it with my Cricut. I loved the colors on this vase, but it did have a big crack in it, so I ended up leaving that behind. I thought this was so cute for Christmas next year. I'm gonna put it on our coffee bar. And then I grabbed this Zadig and Voltaire sweater. I missed a lot of stains on it. This is your reminder to double check items before you grab them. But I did get this vintage Mickey Mouse sweater. A very quick thrift with me today because I didn't find too much, but I did grab this Peloton sports bra for Poshmark and also this Zaya activewear one. I really liked the purple color on it. And then I was excited to find some Lululemon leggings. I liked the white. And then this is my first time finding a C initial on one of these Anthropology mugs, so I was excited to grab it. And then I grabbed another one and this Starbucks mug. Let's go restock my antique booth in Melbourne, Florida. It's called Azalea Vintage Co. It's located at Antiques and Uniques. It is at 1240 Sarno Road. The first thing I do when I walk in is I go and I grab my labels that were printed to price all of the items I brought today. This is how the booth is looking right now. Dalton says hi. I just had a couple things to add today. This magazine rack I love, and then I found a bunch of Faltzgraff lately, so I'm adding that collection to a spot on the shelves. I had also recently found these Spring Blossom Pyrex salt and pepper shakers, so I'm adding that to the set that I have there. And then this is what it was looking like when we finished up. I grabbed some items I wanted to bring back and list on Etsy. And then
a £175 vintage mystery box with me. Kids reversible Harley jacket, Fila fleece, Nike golf hat, Ralph Lauren shirt, Champion hoodie, Eagle sweat, True Religion jeans, Adidas bag, Champion sweat, North Face jacket, Carhartt jeans, 49ers sweat, Ralph jumper. We're not done fancy apart.
And this day they had all sale tags for 50% off. First stop was the dress section. I did find this stunning maxi dress with the ruffles at the end and this polka dot dress. The store has a whole aisle dedicated to plus size, which I love. I've been obsessed with off the shoulder tops and I found two. Found this fur coat and these jackets. Checking out the shoes and there were so many cute ones, but not in my size. Found these stunning lingerie pieces. Kind of regretting not getting this pink jacket. Heading over to the men's jeans. and I found my 569 style jeans, but not in my size. Fur coat and these bags. I was looking for my fiance and this was our whole cart. He showed me he found all these luxury vintage ties.
Being with me all day. Here's the fit. And let's get started with the sweaters. Obviously, that is where I run to when I get to the thrift store. Then I check button-ups. I'm always looking for anything embroidered. So this one with the teddy bears gardening was a no-brainer. Whatever that is, and take a break, and now we're moving on. Next thrift store, as soon as I walk in, I found this super funky vintage windbreaker and this beautiful rainbow sweater. When I tell you I ran because I saw this thing across the room and checked the price and nearly cried. Anyways, checked accessories, home goods, found this little smiley face mug, and here's some things I didn't get that I wish I did get. Last stop of the day and I'm immediately devastated because there's no match to that earring. However, finding this wild rainbow cocktail sweater really just made my whole day and forget about all my problems. Here's some other cute things, but my favorite was this rainbow polka dot couch, which I will forever regret not buying. But unfortunately, I have no room for it because I have too many thrifted clothes. So follow to see and shop.
Another doll worth ridiculous money. Back at the thrift and I found this lunette doll from the Big Comfy Couch. Now this is original to the 90s. If you can find her doll Molly, she sells for $40 to $60, but this one sells for about $70 to $90.
Here's another everything I found at the thrift store in the first 10 minutes.
Look at this maxi dress moment. This tag. Oh! This perfect vintage slip skirt. This skirt? Are you kidding me with that netting? This jacket. Insane set. Hold on, let me show you. So the skirt looks like a scarf, but it's not. It's like a whole ass asymmetrical skirt. And then just this blue tank top that I think I want to crop and we can make it a whole look. A little LA Intimates moment. And the vintage Victoria's Secret one. Ah! This Esprit backpack. Look at that sexy buckle. Look at that sexy buckle. A literal Girl Scout skirt. Oh, my childhood unlocked. I was the worst Girl Scout in the entire state of Ohio. I hate the outdoors and camping.
A few things at the thrift store today that I usually don't see. Number one is an English riding saddle. I used to ride horses and these things are expensive. So if you ride horses, this might be a great find. But something I do see a lot are cute prints like this in frames that I do not like. And I have too many of these at home. This Goodwill almost always has a set of bar stools in this exact same spot. I thought this chair was really cute from afar. Up close, it's not that comfortable, but it's still a vibe. Granted, it isn't a real one, but I've never seen a stoplight at a Goodwill. And finally, I thought this matching set was really cute for someone. But
lock that's so unique and worth more than you think. Back at the thrift store, and not only does this Philips alarm clock have a great speaker in it, this thing actually wakes you up as the sun would when it rises. This alarm clock gradually gets brighter and wakes you up peacefully. Alarm clocks with this feature usually sell from $30 to $60.
The day after Christmas, and we're obviously going to the thrift store right now. It's always like really good after no one was in it on Christmas Day. Okay, first find of the day. Oh my god, this. This top is gorge. Low-rise flare, Route 66, babies. Oof. This Kenneth Cole bag, and this. Literally getting both, I love them. Okay, wait, these are sick. Oh my god, then I turned around and saw these. Stop it. Ugh, these do look too small. These Cole Haans. Stop it, not the Halstons. Okay, the shoes are insane today.
Get in there with your friends.
Very exclusive designer piece. Very exclusive, very expensive.
For real, look at the dresses I found. This one. Look at the neckline.
Thrift with me at the bins to resell for a profit. I started in the clothes where I found this Madewell skirt and then found a Lululemon tank. I quickly moved on from the clothes though because my sister just wanted to get to the shoes. I grabbed these Mark Fisher sandals worth about $25 and bricks I'll grab in almost any condition. And then my best find of the day were these teaks. These should clean up and sell for a pretty nice profit. I ended up giving this single dance go to the woman who had the match, and I was rewarded because my sister found a whole bunch of hunter boots. Then I grabbed these Crocs worth about $20 and some Tory Burch flats. These are always a popular style. My designer find of the day were these kids Prada shoes, and wait, there's another one, these Louboutins, but I have no idea if these are authentic. I'll have to do some research. I was really sad to leave this single fry behind, but hopefully someone found the mate. And then here's a pair of Corkies, these should sell for about $30, and a pair of Picolinos, they make nice leather shoes, and a pair of Sorel to end the day.